too, sir. I wanted to go off, but Jesus said no.
All I wanted was black nail polish, and I wanted my nails to stay on, and I didn't get that.
I did this. You tried this.
Attention, Elizabeth customers.
That's my sweat. That's my stuff. Give it back. Three words. I said Tris!
To the nail shop, I go in there and I ask for specific things. For whatever reason, they feel to ask me as many questions as they can about what else that I need that I didn't ask them about when I'm in the chair.
You want eyebrow?
No, I just want a filling.
You sure you don't want eyebrow? How about pedicure?
No, I'm fine.
You want gel? You want gel? You feel gel? Ew, nice.
No, I'm fine. I'm gonna be back here in 2 weeks anyway. I'm here all the time. There's no use in me giving you UV gel.
Oh, okay. You want wax?
First of all, not only is it annoying, but it's like what you trying to say? You trying to say my eyebrows crusty? You trying to say my feet is crusty?
Oh, they are kind of crusty right now. I hope you guys can't see them right now. They're ashy. I mean, I just got them done. Like, they cute with lotion on them, but there's no lotion on them right now. So, yeah. Let me put my foot down.
But, like, damn, like, what you trying to say? You trying to say I got a mustache? I need to wax it? Like, damn. I asked you for a filling. Just give me the filling, bruh. Just give me the filling. And like, a lot of times they like to like offer their opinions for ish, and it's just like, boy, like, I ain't asked you for your opinion. One time I went to the nail salon, I was turning like 16 or something. I've been getting my nails done since I was 15. I was turning 16 at the time. And the guy was just like, oh, let me do this for you, let me do this design with this color. And I, at the time, like when I first started getting my nails done, all I got was black. As crazy emo as that probably sounds, like, all I got was black nails. My nails were always black. And if they weren't black, they were like nude or something. And two of the colors you know that I really hate is blue and purple. Okay, I really hate blue and purple. Two of the colors, I really don't like them. I really don't. Like, maybe I'll settle for like a navy blue or like a deep blue, but I don't like sky blue. I don't like any of that. Purple, I don't like lavender. I don't like all that. I like deep colors. Like, maybe if it's the dark purple or the dark blue, I'll accommodate. But other than that, I don't like purple and I don't like blue. So the guy's like, oh, let me do purple on your nails with this design. It's gonna look amazing. You're gonna love it. He puts it on me and I hate it. I hate it, I hate it, I hate it. Had to spend my birthday with these nails. I was so highly upset. And then not only that, my nails started popping off. And I'm just like, boy, like, I was there at least three times that same week to fix my nail. And I paid the first time to get it fixed because I thought it was just me, because one of them popped off. I was opening my locker in high school. So I was like, okay, maybe it's just my fault. But it had only been like, it wasn't even a week. It was like 4 to 5 days. So I'm like, I went there the second or third time. I was like, y'all hope y'all don't expect me to pay for this, because this is y'all fault. Like, I'm not paying for this no more. And they're like, oh no, you have to pay for it. You need to pay for it. I was like, if I'm paying for this, then he need to be fired, because no, like, it's absolutely ridiculous that I have to keep coming back over here for something that I shouldn't be coming back for. Like, it's been less than a week and my nails is popping off. So no, eventually he actually did get fired, thank God, because I'm sure he was messing up everything else's nails too and crushing dreams.
All I wanted was black nail polish, and I wanted my nails to stay on, and I didn't get that.
The thing I really don't like about nail shops is the fact that they always feel like they're right. They always feel like, I don't know, like, they're the only businesses I know that argue with the customer. Like, what? I don't understand. A lot of them do not know the meaning of customer service. Like, absolutely not. Another time I went to the nail store, I was with my friend, and it was her birthday, and she wanted to get her nails done or whatever, and she's a very quiet person. She's not, like, one to talk or speak up or anything like that. So, of course, I went with her, because I was like, boy, it's your birthday. You know, we ain't gonna let them do your nails lit. Like, you gonna be lit. They ain't gonna play. You know? But I didn't think anything was gonna really happen. But as they're doing her nails, like, her nails crooked. Like, one of her nails is, like, literally, like, I don't even know, like, basically, like, this shit was crisscross, another one, like, looking crazy. Like, her nails was about to look like a whole gang sign, guys, a whole gang sign. So I asked the guy, I'm like, you know her nail's crooked, right? And he's like, it's not crooked. And I'm like, no, her nail's crooked. And he's trying to ignore me at this point, and I'm like, okay, like, I don't understand, like, how hard is it to fix a crooked nail? So then he starts going off on me, like, who are you talking to? Who are you talking to, sir? I wanted to go off, but But Jesus said no. So I let him rock. Feel me? I let him rock. I let him rock. I let him rock. Eventually, he ends up taking the nail off anyway and doing it over because, of course, I was right. Her nail was, like, dumb crooked. Like, I couldn't even, like, lie about that. I couldn't fabricate that. Like, her nail was really crooked. So I actually got banned from that nail store. Like, I'm not allowed to go in there, but I still go in there anyway to get my eyebrows done because, like, they do a really good job at doing my brows. But, like, goddamn, like, I told you something was wrong. So just fix it. Like, don't argue with the customer. Even though I wasn't the one getting the nails done, like, boy, like, obviously from the outside looking in, it's crooked. So what do you think people gonna say to her when she out here on her birthday trying to turn up and have fun and her nails look disgusting? Just fix it. I'm not trying to be racist, but I only let people of Asian descent do my nails, okay? And most likely, I will not let females do my nails. Because every time a female does my nails do not turn out well. I only let males do it, and they have to be like Vietnamese, Korean, or something like that. One time, I went to a Hispanic nail shop. So I go there, and you know, lady's doing my nails. And the thing is, I don't like when people are running me a service and they're not paying attention. I don't want you eating food. I don't want you on the phone. I mean, I guess you can have conversations with your coworkers, but I don't want all of that stuff going on while you're doing my hair, while you're doing my nails, while you're doing anything for me. You're not gonna do as good as a job as if you were paying attention fully, like I am paying. This lady was on the phone, watching a novella, and filing my nails. Not only was she doing that, but she was doing it hard, like real, like hard. Like, boy, she could have set out a fire on my nails the way she was going. Ends up cutting me. Again, Jesus said no, so I let her rock. I am pissed off to the gods at this point. It wasn't even a little cut, like she really cut me deep. Like I was bleeding, like passion of the Christ, Jesus on the cross bleeding. All right, okay, not really. But like seriously, like I was bleeding, like I was going, it was really going bad. And I'm just like, boy. And like she's like, oh, sorry. What you mean, oh, sorry? Like, my thing is, like, I understand this apology, but, like, she wasn't even remorseful for what she done. And she still continued to talk on the phone, and she still continued to watch the novella. I don't know what it was, but, like, she put some little glue thing on me. I don't know what it was. I don't know why they put it on me. It could have been freaking AIDS or something in a bottle. I wouldn't even know. I don't even think I paid for it. I was just like, yo, I ain't paying for this. Like, I was bleeding, and I was hurting for days. Like, my thing was all red and disgusting for a while. Like, no, I ain't paying for this. So like, yeah, I'm sorry, I only let people of Asian descent do my nails. No offense to the Hispanic people or the black people or anybody else that do nails. But if you're not of Asian descent, I'm not letting you touch my shit. It's like, boy. And most likely if you're a female, you're not gonna touch my ish either. It's very rare. I ain't got time for it. Oh snap, it's raining outside. So basically, moral of the story is, when you are searching for a nail shop, make sure you find a nail shop that is clean, and make sure you don't just go to any nail shop. Make sure you ask around, like, what's the best one, and you look it up on Google and all that good stuff. Because, like, seriously, I've been to some really good ones and to some really bad ones. So, like, watch out for all of that. I just wanted to talk about the nail store. So, like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'ma see y'all next time.